Hey guys, in this brand new video, we're going to take a look at the equilibrium constant. Now, we're going to say that the variable we use to illustrate our equilibrium constant is the variable k. And we're going to say k is a number equal to the ratio of products to reactants at a given temperature. Why do I say at a given temperature? Because we're going to say that temperature directly affects our equilibrium constant K. Increasing the temperature will increase our K value. Decreasing our temperature will decrease our K value. Now we're going to say it's a ratio of products to reactants. So we're going to say here that K equals products over reactants. Now we're going to say that K is important because its magnitude tells us how far to the left or to the right our chemical reaction is at a given temperature. So we're going to say if K is greater than 1, then products are favored over reactants. And think about it. This makes sense because we said K equals products over reactants. So let's say our products are 10 and our reactants are 1. K equals 10, definitely greater than 1. We're going to say when products are favored over our reactants, that means we're making more products. How do we make more products? By going in the forward direction. So the forward direction would be favored. Now in the opposite way, if K is less than 1, so let's say we have, in this case, products are 1, but our reactants are 10. We'd have a K less than 1. So in this case, if K is less than 1, then reactants are favored over products, which means our reaction is heading in the reverse direction. So the reverse direction would be favored. So just remember these two differences, when K is greater than 1, when K is less than 1. Now, what if we say K was equal to 1? We know that this is products over reactants. So that means that our products and reactants would have to be equal. Let's say they're both 10. 10 over 10 is 1. So when K equals 1, we're going to say both our reactant and our product amounts are equal to one another. Now we're going to say the equilibrium constant K takes into account all the states of matter except two. It doesn't look at solids and it doesn't look at liquids. It ignores those two states for matter.